The gentleman from Florida.
Director Mueller, can you state with confidence that the Steele dossier was not part of Russia's disinformation campaign?
No, I said it in the, my opening statement. Part of the building of the case was predated me, and by at least 10 months.
Yeah, I mean, Paul Manafort's alleged crimes regarding tax evasion predated you. You had no problem charging them. And matter of fact, this Steele dossier predated the Attorney General, and he didn't have any problem answering the question. When Senator Cornyn asked the Attorney General the exact question I asked you, Director, the Attorney General said, and I'm quoting, "No, I can't state that with confidence. And that's one of the areas I'm reviewing. I'm concerned about it, and I don't think it's entirely speculative." Now, if something is not entirely speculative, then it must have some factual basis, but you identify no factual basis regarding the dossier or the possibility that it was part of the Russia disinformation campaign. Now, Christopher Steele's reporting is referenced in your report. Steele reported to the FBI that senior Russian foreign ministry figures, along with other Russians, told him that there was, and I'm quoting from the Steele dossier, "extensive evidence of conspiracy between the Trump campaign team and the Kremlin." So here's my question. Did Russians really tell that to Christopher Steele, or did he just make it all up and was he lying to the FBI?
Let me back up a second, if I could, and say, as I said earlier, with regard to the Steele, that's beyond my purview.
No, it is exactly your purview, Director Mueller, and here's why. Only one of two things is possible, right? Either Steele made this whole thing up and there were never any Russians telling him of this vast criminal conspiracy that you didn't find, or Russians lied to Steele. Now, if Russians were lying to Steele to undermine our confidence in our duly elected president, that would seem to be precisely your purview, because you stated in your opening that the organizing principle was to fully and thoroughly investigate Russia's interference. But you weren't interested in whether or not Russians were interfering through Christopher Steele. And if Steele was lying, then you should have charged him with lying like you charged a variety of other people. But you say nothing about this in your report.
Well,
meanwhile, Director, you're quite loquacious on other topics. You write 3,500 words about the June 9 meeting between the Trump campaign and Russian lawyer Veselnitskaya. You write on page 103 of your report that the president's legal team suggested, and I'm quoting from your report, that the meeting might have been a setup by individuals working with the firm that produced the Steele reporting. So I'm going to ask you a very easy question, Director Mueller. On the week of June 9, who did Russian lawyer Veselnitskaya meet with more frequently? The Trump campaign or Glenn Simpson, who was functionally acting as an operative for the Democratic National Committee?
Well, what I think is missing here is the fact that this is under investigation elsewhere in the Justice Department.
And if I can finish, sir.
And consequently, it's not within my purview. Department of Justice and FBI should be responsive to questions on this particular issue.
It is absurd to suggest that a operative for the Democrats was meeting with this Russian lawyer the day before and the day after the Trump Tower meeting, and yet that's not something you referenced. Now, Glenn Simpson testified under oath he had dinner with Veselnitskaya the day before and the day after this meeting with the Trump team. Do you have any basis, as you sit here today, to believe that Steele was lying?
As I said before, and I'll say again, it's not my purview. Others are investigating what you
So it's not your purview to look into whether or not Steele's lying. It's not your purview to look into whether or not anti-Trump Russians are lying to Steele. And it's not your purview to look at whether or not Glenn Simpson was meeting with the Russians the day before and the day after you write 3,500 words about the Trump campaign meeting. So I'm wondering how these decisions are guided. I look at the Inspector General's report. I'm citing from page 404 of the Inspector General's report. It states, Page stated, Trump's not ever going to be president, right? Right. Strzok replied, no, he's not. We'll stop it. Also in the Inspector General's report, there's someone identified as Attorney Number 2. Attorney Number 2, this is page 419, replied, hell no, and then added, viva la resistance. Attorney Number 2 in the Inspector General's report and Strzok both worked on your team, didn't they?
Pardon me? Can you ask?
They both worked on your team, didn't they?
I know. I heard Strzok. Who else were you talking about?
Attorney Number 2 identified in the Inspector General's report.
Okay. And the question was?
Did he work for you? The guy who said viva la resistance.
Peter Strzok worked for me for a period of time. Yes.
Yeah, but so did the other guy that said viva la resistance. And here's what I'm kind of noticing, Director Mueller. When people associated with Trump lied, you threw the book at them. When Christopher Steele lied, nothing. And so it seems to be that when Glenn Simpson met with Russians, nothing, when the Trump campaign met with Russians, 3,500 words. And maybe the reason why there are these discrepancies in what you focused on is because the team was so biased.
Time of the gentleman has expired.
Pledge to
Mr.
stop
Jeffries
Trump.
Of New